morning, children. In today's class, we are going to learn problems based on cross product. First, let us see the various properties of cross product to apply in the problems.
As we recall the definition for A cross B, which is mod A mod B sine theta n cap. As we see here, vector A, vector B, from A to B, the angle is theta. N cap is an unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. So, it is shown as a dotted line because N cap is not on the plane, it is perpendicular to the plane. If I put in this way, it is minus N cap. When I say B cross A, if it is A cross B, vector ABN form a right-handed system. But when I want B cross A, vector B, A and minus N form the right-handed system. So, it is minus N vector. So, when I compare, these two are different in symbol. They are equal in magnitude but different in symbol. So, we claim vector product is not commutative. Look at the parallelogram formed by the adjacent sides A vector and B vector. If I want the area of the parallelogram, we find it as A cross B. Vector area is A cross B, and area, when I want, I can take modulus of it. Whenever two vectors are parallel, what is the angle between them? This is A vector, this is B vector. Angle between them is zero. If I put theta is zero, sine zero becomes zero. So, zero into anything gives us zero. So, we claim when A and B are parallel, A cross B is zero. But if A cross B is 0, we have three options because we know the value for A cross B. So, either mod A 0 or mod B 0 or sine theta is 0. So, mod A 0 or mod B 0 or sine theta 0 tells us the vectors are parallel. So, whenever I say cross product is 0, and A and B are not zero, I can claim A is parallel to B. Also, whenever A and B are parallel, I can claim cross product is zero. Now, if I say A cross A, using this idea, A and A are parallel, or I can say collinear. So, A cross A, I cross I, J cross J, K cross K. When the vectors are same, cross product is zero. If the vectors are perpendicular, see, we know I goes along X axis, J goes along Y axis and K goes along Z axis. And we know they are all mutually perpendicular. When I say they are mutually perpendicular, what happens to the cross product? I cross J, I apply in this formula, mod I 1 mod J 1 sine, angle between them is 90. So modulus of I 1 modulus of J 1 sine 90 is 1. What is the unit vector perpendicular to I and J? We know I, J are along X and Y axis. So, the unit vector perpendicular to X and Y is obviously Z axis and the vector along which we have K. So, K vector is the unit vector perpendicular to I and J. So, whenever I have I cross J, my answer is K. And whenever I have J cross K, it is I. K cross I, it is J. So, I, J, K. We put cyclically. I cross J is K. J cross K is I. K cross I is J. So we have cyclically I cross J, J cross K, K cross I. If I change the direction as before, the sign changes. So I cross J is K tells us J cross I will be minus K. J cross K is I tells us K cross J will be minus I. And similarly, I can say for the other things. When I have M into A, N into B vector, where M and N are non-zero scalars, I can keep M and N all out here, or I can combine with A vector, I can combine with B vector, or I can combine in what way I want. So this we call scalar multiplication in cross product. Now the distributive law, let us remember. Cross is out, B plus C is in. How are we to split it? A cross B plus A cross C. Similarly, plus is in, cross is out. It is A cross C plus B cross C. From here, what is A cross B? Mod A, mod B, sin theta, n cap. When I don't want n cap, I should take modulus. So whenever I don't want n cap, because modulus of n cap is 1. So what is modulus of A cross B? Mod A, mod B, sin theta. From here, what is sin theta? I can bring A and B down. So we have the formula. Sin theta is modulus of A cross B by mod A mod B. Or if I simply want theta, angle between the two vectors, I can bring sin to the right as sin inverse. So it is sin inverse mod A cross B by mod A mod B. From the same formula, when I don't take modulus, I have n cap. When I take modulus, n cap modulus is 1, so we leave it. Therefore, if I want n cap, I can say A cross B by mod A cross B. But when the vectors are A and B, unit vector can be upward or it will be downward below the plane. So naturally, I need to put plus or minus symbol. How are we to perform cross product or vector product when A vector and B vector are given? So when A vector is A1i plus A2j plus A3k and B vector is B1i plus B2j plus B3k, to perform cross product, we use the determinant idea. First row, I, J, K, the three unit vectors. Second row, A vector components, A1, A2, A3. And third row, B vector components, say B1, B2, B3. As I expand the determinant, I get A cross B answer. Now let us continue with the exercise problems. Exercise 8.4, question number 1, find the magnitude of A cross B if A and B are given. Let us find out A cross B. The formula, use the determinant. First row, we put I, J, K. Second row, A vector components. Say the numbers 2, 1, 3. Next row, we write B vector components. 3, 5, minus 2. We all know how to expand the determinant. Remember the symbols plus, minus, plus. As I expand, I vector into. Hide the row, hide the column. 1, 3, 5, minus 2. Minus J vector. Again, hide the row, hide the column. 2, 3, 3, minus 2. Remember, whichever I want, that particular row and column, we hide it. Plus, K into. Again, where is K coming? First row, third column. So we are left with 2, 1, 3, 5. As I expand, it is I into minus 2, 5, 3, 7, 15. Multiply, multiply, subtract. Minus 2, minus 15. Minus j into minus 4, minus 9. Plus k into 10, minus 3. As we simplify, it is minus 17i minus 13 into minus j plus 13j. 10 minus 3 is 7, so I get 7k. This is A cross B. My question is to find modulus of A cross B. The word magnitude tells us we need the modulus, that is square root of squares. Minus 17 square, 13 square plus 7 square. As I simplify, it is 289, 169, 49. As we add, we get square root of 507. So let us take and write the answer. Magnitude of A cross B equals root of 507, and hence the problem is done. Question number 2, show that A cross B plus C plus B cross C plus C cross A plus B equals 0. Let us start from left hand side. As we know the distributive law, A cross B plus C can be written as A cross B plus A cross C. So we just put arrow marks, A cross B plus A cross C. Similarly, the second one, I have B cross C, B cross A. And the third one, C cross A, C cross B. Now, I need to show 0. That means the terms must mutually get cancelled. So here I have A cross B, here I have B cross A. Reverse. Whenever I reverse, the sign changes. So first three, let us write as it is. A cross B plus A cross C plus B cross C. So first three terms we have just copied. Reverse, minus A cross B. Reverse, minus A cross C. And the third one, as I reverse, it is minus B cross C. So we know cross product is not commutative. So whenever I reverse the terms, it becomes negative. Now we see A cross B minus A cross B cancels. A cross C minus A cross C gets cancelled. B cross C minus B cross C also gets cancelled, leaving us 0, and 0 is the RHS. Question number 3, find the vectors of magnitude 10 root 3 that are perpendicular to the plane which contains the two vectors. Naming the two vectors as A and B, we know unit vector perpendicular to the plane containing A and B is n cap. N cap, the formula goes plus or minus A cross B by mod A cross B. But the question claims the vector of magnitude 10 root 3. So the perpendicular vector of magnitude 10 root 3 is multiply n cap by 10 root 3. Now we have to find out A cross B, modulus of A cross B, and that answer. Let us multiply by 10 root 3 to arrive at the required vector. What is A cross B? Put determinant symbol I, J, K. A vector components 1, 2, 1. B vector components 1, 3, 4. As I expand, I know the symbols plus, minus, plus. I vector into hiding the row and column. It is 8 minus 3 minus J vector into hiding the row and column 4 minus 1. Plus K vector into hiding the row and column 3 minus 2. As I simplify, 5i vector minus 3j vector plus k vector. I need to find modulus of A cross B. Square root of squares. 5 square minus 3 square plus 1 square. It is 25 plus 9 plus 1, that is root of 35. What is my question actually? I want perpendicular vector. My answer is 10 root 3 n cap. It is 10 root 3 n cap is plus or minus. What is A cross B? 5i minus 3j plus k divided by what is the modulus? Root of 35. Hence, the perpendicular vector to the plane containing A vector and B vector with magnitude 10 root 3 is plus or minus 10 root 3 by root of 35 into 5i minus 3j plus k vector.